Ngayon po ay kapistahan ni Santo Papa Juan Paolo II, Pope John Paul II, and I believe most of us who are attending now, either public or online, meron sa kanyang alaala. Bakit po pala he was quite memorable to all of us? There are two reasons. Una, he was a pope for 26 years. Asaka yung kanyang papacy din, yun din ang time na kung saan nagbo-boom ang mass communication media. From radio, during his time, sumikat naman yung TV, pati nga yung internet, naabot pa ni Pope John Paul II because he died on 2005. So that's why many who are living right now has the best memories about him. Pangalawa din, because he visited the Philippines twice. 1981, he canonized Saint Lorenzo Ruiz of Manila, at he was here also ng 1995 during the World Youth Day. Tapos naalala ko, grade 5 ako noon, sabi ng teacher namin, oh, for 3 days na yan ang gagawin ninyo, you have to watch the television. Subaybayan daw ang itinerary ni Pope John Paul. At di ko makalimutan, pag yung Pope Mobile dadaan sa may mga baby, the Pope will gladly come down as yung ilapit yung baby at saka to kiss and embrace. At alam nyo, siguro after some years, yung family ng mga may baby na yun na kiss, dinocument yun sa isang documentary film at nagpapatunay sila na gumaan yung buhay nila. Yung bata lumaking disiplinado at naging prosperous yung buhay nila, testifying na kaya nga, just in case kung may mga special intention kayo, you bring it today to Pope John Paul II. And for our purpose for today, may dalaw po tayong pagninilayan sa kanyang mga turo at buhay na makatulong sa atin sa pang-araw-araw. Una, yung si Pope John Paul kasi po, ang kanyang isa sa mga main work as a Pope, yung building unity and peace. At pangalawa naman, the second point we're going to talk about, yung kanyang write-up on Christian meaning of pain and suffering. So we'll go first to the first point, yung paano ba magdala o pamamahala, how to deal when there is differences, yung pagkaiba ng ugali at pananaw sa buhay. Sabi ni Jesus sa Gospel, just in case meron kang hindi maayos na nakakaunawaan, doon pa lang along the way, you settle already the problem. Do not anymore wait na makarating pa kayo doon sa courthouse where you will be put to prison. Ang point na naman ni Jesus, if there are differences in our family, in our relationship with one another, settle the differences immediately. Huwag na itong hayaan na lumala. The key word is to settle. Pero ang tanong kasi ngayon, how to effectively settle our differences? Malaga ito pag-usapan kasi relationship is crucial to families, brothers and sisters. So, at if we don't have the tools how to properly manage our relationship, especially pag mainit na ang ulo, maraming nag-aaway-away. Kaya nga maganda talaga, we have to always remember, kailangan natin talaga tanggapin na iba-iba talaga ugali ng tao. Expect that not everyone will agree with you. At naging maliwanag po ito kay Pope John Paul II early on, that we have to respect each other's differences. Kahit kayong mga kambal, magkamukha na sila, pareho pa ang mga height, sukat ng damit, tapos lumaki pa sa parehong magulang, iba-iba pa rin ang ugali. Kasi if you push the person to agree with you, what if they don't agree with you? Eh, syempre, you will consider the person your opponent or enemy. And for Jesus, it does not like that. Kasi minsan, when we look at the person as an enemy, hindi natin tutulungan, or we keep hatred over the person. Kaya ngayon mag-asawa karamihan, oh, bakit kayo nag-separate? Bakit kayo nag-divorce? Kasi Father, we have what you call irreconcilable differences. At we have realized kasi Father, we are incompatible. So that's the... But if we do have the tools to handle differences, baka it will make our life more peaceful. Lalo sa ating mga Seminarista nandito ngayon sa loob ng simbahan, kasi naalala ko na Seminarista ako. Nang first year ako, all the way from the province, excited ako pumunta ng seminaryo. For the first 1 week, it was a bed of roses. But after 2 weeks na, naku, may mga tinik pala dito sa loob ng seminaryo. Ang unang tinik ko noon, yung mga kaklase ko, especially when there is a clash of personality, when there is, yung nag-awayan na, binibiro ka na, ang iba parang walang-walang modo ang iba, naalala ko. Parang, pinalaki ba ito ng magulang niya na maayos? Well, yun lang naman aking, in my simple, ano lang naman, going back to my, ano, it was my experience. Back, I might be wrong. Pero naisip ko, paano na yung mag-asawa after Hollywood, after honeymoon stage? Anyway, nabuti na lang yung aming pari that time, pinapaala sa amin lagi na, please be patient and understanding to one another, kasi you come from different places, you come from different family background and orientation. Dun, so sabi ng pari namin, do not give up to one another, but seek to reconcile and be united. And that's the point of Pope John Paul II. That's why his teaching is very important to all of us, to work for unity, not really for uniformity. Ibig sabihin, mga mag-asawa, honey, dapat parehong damit natin, ha? Dapat parehong sapatos natin. No, hindi, the world is not like that. We can be different at the same time, united. How? According to Pope John Paul II, by seeking to understand, by listening, by reaching out. No wonder si Pope John Paul II is the most traveled pope, because ang point niya, baka in my traveling, I can gather the nations to become one and united to one another. And how, sabi pa ni Pope John Paul II, we can live peacefully by coexisting. Meaning, I acknowledge the person that he or she is entitled to exist and validate his own opinion. And no to violence, di ko siya sasaktan just because iba kanyang pananaw. Di ko siya sasaktan. So, and I will not give up on him. So that's the point of Pope John Paul. That's why we can really learn a lot from him. As sabi sa kanya, sabi niya, you have got to widen your perspective. Kasi kung nagkakaiba naman kayo, baka is isang area lang. So do not give up on the person, because malay mo, there are other areas you can be together. Like working with the Muslim. Sabi niya, we cannot agree on our belief kasi we have to respect them, but we can agree on developing poverty alleviation, erasing human trafficking. So there are many unlimited possibilities. That's why sa mga magkakapatid ngayon, sa mga nag-away-away, sa mga mag-asawa, do not immediately give up on one another. Baka may kailangan na may mag-adjust sa isa't isa. And here we come to the second point of Pope John Paul II. Change and apologize if it's necessary. Kasi sabi niya, we are not always right. We must be teachable. We have to admit our mistake because we have to grow to one another. So huwag niyo pong kalimutan ang mga magandang turo ni Pope John Paul II. And last, yung kanyang second point I would like to highlight, yung turo niya po about human suffering. Alam niyo ba, among all popes, siya lang po ang nag-focus din sa to teach on Christian meaning of suffering. Because he also undergirgan a lot of suffering. 8 years old pa lang siya, his mother died. Can you imagine growing up without mother next to you? Tapos, dalawa lang sila magkapatid. Tatlo sana, kasi yung isang younger sister niya died earlier. Tapos yung kapatid niya naman na lalaki sana, na doctor, died also. Kaya nga, he grew up with his father only. Pero, he did not allow those situation to limit him. Tapos, isa pa pinagdaanan niya yung ng time nila, yung country nila, Poland was invaded by Russia and Germany, nag-work din siya for 4 years po sa factory at na gusto pa siyang assassinate when he was a pope, and he got Parkinson's sickness. No wonder he was able to contribute to the church how to look at suffering. So allow me to present to you, in short, how Pope John Paul II teaches us about suffering. Only 3 points. First, sa communist at Nazi Germany kasi, para sa kanila, pag ang tao nagkasakit na, mahina na yan, di na mapakinabangin sa factory. Sa mga Nazi, dapat superior race. Kung may bungi ka, may bungi, may kulang, naku, i-liquidate ka na. Kasi ikaw ay to be treated as liability. You will just cause problem to the state. Gagastusan ka lang. But for Pope John Paul II, no. No. Because ang tao may dignity. May dignity. Sabi, may value. He does not lose his value only because of a defect. So always remember that you will always remain useful, worthwhile, even you are not anymore productive because of a certain ailment. Pangalawa naman, at the time ni Pope John Paul II, malakas yung materialism because yung Europe was that time was very, very rich. They find security in materialism. Ang problema, when people lose their material wealth, they find no more meaning, no more hope. That's why they commit suicide. But ang teaching naman ni Pope John Paul II, money is not all there is. Mahanap pa naman yan. The world will not end only because you lose money. Who knows, there are other areas you can find your way to the world. So always look other areas. Just always widen your perspective. True faith, according to Pope John Paul II, always widen. It's only your mind who limits it. But faith will try to make it unlimited. You can still begin again, according to Pope John Paul II. Jesus is your ultimate security. Pinapaalala niya sa Europe and all over the world. In addition, sabi pa ni Pope John Paul, your suffering can be your way to holiness, your transformation, and salvation. Sa kanyang write-up on Christian meaning of suffering, sabi niya, your suffering is educational, and sometimes the best teacher. Educational. It teaches us a lot. It teaches a lot of determination, courage. It makes us stronger. And third naman, yung issue on euthanasia. Kasi some people, pag nagkasakit na, wala ng pera, for them, life is pointless already. Pointless. Tusukan mo na yan ng ano, poison para, tusukan mo na para, yet that's euthanasia. No more. I will choose to end my own life. But for Pope John Paul II, sabi niya, no, offer your suffering to the church. Offer. Hindi yan pointless kasi even your suffering can be your way of your missionary service by participating in the mission of Christ. So to all of you listening right now, or if you have a relative suffering right now in the hospital, kindly tell all these beautiful messages from Pope John Paul II. In closing, summarizing everything, it's all about perseverance and faithfulness until the end. Pinanood ko po, to close his homily, napanood ko po yung what happened to the when Pope John Paul II died. What happened inside the room in his deathbed? According sa insider, sa isang documentary, the moment na declared patay na si Pope John Paul II, there was silence in the room. There was no crying. Usually kasi sa Vatican, when a Pope died, they prayed the prayer for the salvation of the soul. But after long silence, you know what they did? They sang thankful hymn. Nagpapasalamat sila. Bakit? Before them, somebody who told them how to live faithfully until the end. That no suffering can take, he did not allow suffering to take him down. He did not allow suffering to take down his faith, his hope, and love for God. And that's also a good message to all of you. Never allow anybody anyone to take down your life, your happiness, your faith, and your love for God. God bless everyone.